Can you just test that, Erika?
Testing.
Okay, that's good, yeah.
Okay, got it?
I can hear.
Sorry?
Do it one more time.
Testing.
Okay, hold on, I'll just go to one more.
Okay. Good morning. Testing. Oh yeah, I can hear that.
Everyone, can I ask you to take your seats so we can get ready for our lovely breakfast and service? It's okay. And a warm welcome to you all on this lovely summer's day. The Reverend Sharon is away on a much needed vacation. So I will be doing my best to MC this event, but thankfully we have the Reverend Gary Hamblin with us to do the important parts. A warm welcome to everybody, and for those in the room with us here and those who are joining on live stream. We'd like to welcome Erika Chow, Bella, and Jordy, our wonderful musicians this morning. I want to acknowledge with respect and gratitude that we're gathered on the traditional and unceded territory of the Squamish and Tsleilwaututh Nations. Now, there's a few instructions before we start eating. During the breakfast, there's an opportunity for you to write a prayer request. There's paper and a basket over by the lovely pictures over there. You can write a name. We prefer, for respecting anonymity, that you don't write the person's surname. First names only, and these prayers will be read aloud during the prayers. Let us stand, as Gary says, the grace. Then we'll sing and eat.
Let me just talk for a bit and make sure that the microphone is working. Can you hear me? Okay. Let us pray. For food in a world where many walk in hunger, for faith in a world where many walk in fear, for friends in a world where many walk alone, we give you thanks, O Lord. Lord, bless the food upon our dishes, just as you bless the loaves and fishes. Bless the sugar in our tea, that we may stir up our lives for thee. Amen.
Amen. Pardon me, Alice, will you lead us in the gathering chant, please?
A couple more times in different ways. There's a final line, come now and worship the Lord. Then it goes, this is supposed to be Trinity Sunday, I believe. So it's like we have the Most High, and then it's come all you people, come and bless the Savior. And then in the third verse, it's come and bless the Spirit. So we're going to sing it through, and then we'll try have you guys sing it again. And if you don't get it right, then we'll have to go to a third time, which is very much Trinitarian. So,
come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come now and worship the Lord.
Lord is Savior.
Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come now and worship the Lord.
And Spirit.
Come all you people, come and praise the Spirit. Come all you people, come and praise the Spirit. Come all you people. Come and praise the Spirit. Come now and worship the Lord.
I'd like to do this again.
Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come now and worship the Lord. Come now, you people, come and praise the Savior. Come all you people.
That's a very good start to the morning. Okay, so now let's serve up breakfast. You can line up on either side of the breakfast table. Please help yourselves. I think
Thank you. Thank you.
I hope everyone's really enjoyed this yummy breakfast. We have some excellent cooks in this place. Thank you for all who contributed. So we're going to ask you, after I figure out what I'm saying here, Gary's going to do an opening prayer right now. Don't worry if you haven't finished eating yet. You can carry on gently, okay? Thank you.
Let us pray. Thank you, Creator, for being made in your image. Help us to embrace our creative natures, to be purveyors of beauty in the service of the holy. May we experience joy in the small creative acts of the everyday and discover the glory in the gray. O God of love, lead us into dancing. Amen. So I have a question that is entirely reasonable to ask in a congregation. I wouldn't say in church, because we're in the parish hall, but to the congregation. And the question is this: do you know the difference between heaven and hell? Do you know the difference between heaven and hell? I once heard that in Europe, and I'm talking in stereotypes here, I once heard heaven is where the cooks are French, the police are English, the mechanics are German, the lovers are Italian, and the Swiss organize everything. Hell, on the other hand, is where the English are the cooks, the Germans are the police, the French are the mechanics, the Swiss are the lovers, and everything is organized by the Italians. I tell you this story because it's like the confusing image of the nature and shape of God based on the notion of the Trinity, which is what we're celebrating today. This is the day in which we celebrate the Holy Trinity, according to the church year. At least from the description in John's Gospel, where Jesus talks about it, about the Trinity, everything and the way he describes it, everything is backward, out of order, and unintelligible. Three in one, nature and person, Father, Son, and Spirit. Father Richard Rohr says this language is gobbledygook, and our eyes glaze over when we hear or read it. But what does it all mean, and what does it really have to do with us? At the end of the fourth century, church fathers who added the final touch to the Nicene Creed used a Greek word as their inspiration for the foundation of the nature and the shape of God. It's a Greek word that doesn't just tell who God is, it shows in plain language who God is. The word is perichoresis, perichoresis. Peri means circle. The word choresis means dance or choreography. So God is perichoresis. God is like a circle dance. Communion, a flow of communion, interdependence, not just a particle, but a relationship between the particles. That's a contemporary understanding of God in our world, thanks to quantum physics. The Holy Trinity is a circle dance in many ways. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are all different, but they are all one God. They are connected by love, and they move together in harmony, creating the world and all that is in it. The circle dance of the Trinity is a reminder that we are all connected. We are all part of God's family, God's world, and we are all called to love and to serve one another. When we dance together, and I asked Vivian if she'd like to dance at the beginning when I heard the orchestra playing, when we dance together, we create a beautiful and powerful image of God's love. So as we listen to the readings this morning, keep in mind this image of God as a circle dance.
And can we have the first reading? Who's doing the first? Here comes Elizabeth. Thank you.
A reading by Rumi. O day, arise, shine your light, the atoms are dancing. Thanks to God, the universe is dancing, overcome with ecstasy. Free from body and mind, I'll whisper in your ear where their dance is leading them. All the atoms in the air and in the desert are dancing, puzzled and drunken to the ray of light. They seem insane. All these atoms are not so different than we are, happy or miserable, perplexed and bewildered. We are all beings in the ray of light from the beloved. Nothing can be said.
Thank you, Elizabeth. And we'll have our second reading from Thomas Merton.
This morning, we're talking about the divine dance. And before I do the reading, I wondered why it is that the word dance keeps coming up with regard to our ministry or our life. And so I looked up a definition, and it said that dance can be seen as a metaphor for life in a number of ways, but dance requires the dancer to stay balanced and commitment to the movement and to what's happening. And similar balance, therefore, finds us in life as well. So the marketplace sees dancing as a way to engage with and respond to the various challenges and opportunities of life. So here is a reading from Thomas Merton. The Lord plays and diverts himself in the garden of his creation. And if we could go of our own obsession with what we think is the meaning of it all, we might be able to hear his call and follow him in his mysterious cosmic dance. For the world and time are the dance of the Lord in emptiness. The silence of the spheres is the music of a wedding feast. Indeed, we are in the midst of it, and it is in the midst of us, for it beats in our very blood, whether we want it to or not. Yet the fact remains, we are invited to forget ourselves on purpose, cast our awful solemnity to the winds, and join in the general dance. Hear what the Spirit is saying.
Thanks be to God.
So I'll read the gospel for Sunday, which is from Matthew.
Can't hear you.
Can I hear you?
No. Just a moment.
Okay, crystal.
Oh, you heard it. Okay.
I heard the
wow. Isn't that true? Like with computers, if something's not working, you switch it off and you turn it back on. Right? Okay. Well, I read the gospel. It's from Matthew, and then I'll say a few words after that. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others along with you so that every word may be confirmed by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen, even to the church, let such as one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them. And that's the gospel from the 18th chapter of Matthew. But I'm not going to talk about it. I mean, the gospel really talks about relationship as a theme, as far as I'm concerned. So I want to talk about relationship. And I want to do that. I'm going to read three stories that talk about relationship. They're quick stories, and they highlight the need for union amongst us, with God and with each other. The first story is this. Once there was an elderly man, and one evening he was taking his usual walk. He was enjoying the crisp night air and the wind blowing gently. But suddenly, he heard a voice crying out, "Help me, help me!" The man looked around and saw no one, and so he continued his walk. Again, he heard a tiny voice, "Help me, help me!" This time he looked down and he saw a small frog. He gently lifted up the frog and looked at it intently. The frog spoke, "I am really a very beautiful princess. If you kiss me, I will turn back into a princess and I will hug you and kiss you and love you forever." Well, the man thought about it for a moment, and he placed the frog in his top pocket and continued walking. The little frog looked up and out of the pocket and asked, "Why don't you kiss me?" The man responded. He said, "I would like to do that, but truly at this stage of my life, I would rather have a talking frog." I'll come back to this later. And then there's this passage from a book you may have read or the movie you may have seen based on the book. If you like classic movies, the title of the book is Zorba the Greek. How many of you have read or seen the movie of Zorba the Greek? Quite a few. In the passage, Zorba is speaking. He says, "One day when I was a child, an old man took me on his knee and placed his hand on my head as though he were giving me a blessing. Alexis," he said, "I'm going to tell you a secret. You're too small to understand now, but you will understand when you are bigger. Listen, little one, neither the seven stories of heaven nor the seven stories of earth are enough to contain God. But a person's heart can contain God. So be careful, Alexis, and my blessing be with you, never to wound another person's heart." And a final story, a true one. It comes from a priest who was summoned one day to the bishop's office and told, "We're sending you to this old inner city parish. There are some wonderful people there, yet they are old, and the church and the parish has been in decline for 20 years. Just a handful of people left now, so they will not expect much ministry from you. Just go there and visit and do what you can." The young priest's heart sank. This is not what he wanted. And when he got there to this parish, he told the parish, which was comprising three elderly women, the parish council, "I asked God whether I should come here I really wanted to work with young children and families. How can I have a fruitful ministry here? But I'll give it a try. A few months later, he was
visiting the hospital and stopped in to visit a mother.
Oh, your sound's gone up.
Okay, click it on and off again, and see if that works.
Try it now. Okay, it works. A few months later, he was visiting the hospital and stopped to visit a mother with her newborn son. She talked to him of her experience of childbirth. "But worst of all," said the young mother, we had this baby all by ourselves." "What do you mean?" he asked. "Oh," she said, "our parents are far away across the world, and since this is our first baby, it's a little scary for us. We have no one to ask what to do next. Not even our grandparents, who live far away. Most of the other people in our neighborhood are young couples like us. I wish this baby had some grandparents." And suddenly, as you can guess, a light came on in the priest's head. Grandparents, he thought. My God, my parish is full of grandparents. The holy tiny congregation is grandparents. So he talked to the congregation. He talked the congregation into visiting the home of a couple whose baby was born in the neighborhood. Well, the baby visitors, as it soon turned out, were great evangelizing. Young couples in the neighborhood were looking for somebody to be excited about the birth of their child. The church had a surplus of grandparents, and the two got together. And the church was reborn. Where once there was solitude, there was new community, there was union. There was the circle dance. So there are my three stories. Well, what do these three stories have in common? What these three stories have in common is their testimony to every human being's greatest drive, greatest urge, and greatest need. And that is union, togetherness, even if it's with a frog. To put it simply, to be whole, people need union. To be whole, people need relationships. To be whole, people need to have someone in their lives. That's self-evident. Just think for a moment. Vivian?
Thank you, Gary. Sorry about the mic. Okay, I'm going to ask you to refrain from clearing your tables. We're going to do it at the very end of the service, after the announcements and the final blessing, just so we don't have a lot of clattering. Now I invite you at your tables to reflect on the line from Thomas Merton. It's in your bulletin, in the middle here. "The Lord plays and diverts himself in the garden of his creation. And if we could let go of our own obsession with what we think is the meaning of it all, we might be able to hear his call and follow him in his mysterious cosmic dance." So perhaps at your tables, consider the question, what is your creative outlet? No one's is quite the same. So enjoy, just gather around your table host, and if you don't know who that is, they can tell you. and then just have a nice little conversation for a few minutes. And if you still want to write a prayer down for the prayers, you can write it down on a piece of paper and put it in the basket back by the pictures there. Okay? Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I'm sure we all have some very creative outlets, and I wish I could have walked around and heard everybody's. So now we're going to do the prayers of the people, and we're going to ask Lynn Spence to come up, and she will also read the prayers from the basket. Thank you, Lynn.
To the statement, God of love, the response is, hear our prayer. I watched this morning for the light that the darkness has not overcome. I watched for the fire that was in the beginning and that burns still in the brilliance of the rising sun. I watched for the glow of life that gleams in the growing earth and glistens in the sea and sky. I watch for your light, O God, in the eyes of every living creature and in the ever-living flame of my own soul. If the grace of seeing were mine, this day I would glimpse you in all that lives. Grant me the grace of seeing this day. Grant me the grace of seeing. God of love, hear our prayer. In Canada, we pray for our national Anglican Church and our wider Anglican Church in the world. In our diocese, we pray for our leadership. God of love, hear our prayer. We pray for the special needs of our loved ones, David, Rose, Lori, Jan, John W., Peter M., Rosalind Jackson, Jill Dennison, Ernie, Lois, and Debbie. For the people of Ukraine, Iran, Afghanistan, and justice for women, for peace in this troubled world. God of love, hear our prayer. Dear God, set at rest the crowded, hurrying, anxious thoughts within our mind and hearts. Let the peace and quiet of your presence take possession of us. Grant that we may pause and soak in your love, that we may hear what you are saying, that you may allow your spirit to touch our hearts and restore and renew us. Open wide our minds and hearts that we might become passionate believers and joyful followers of you. God of love, hear our prayer. Amen. We bless these wishes for Leanne, Reverend Rhonda, for Sammy, Sandy and family, in memory of Gord, remembering Linda, Sharon, praying for shelter, a home by end of July. Rose and David, in memory of Mom Eileen. Debbie, Ernie, Lois. For my mom on her birthday. Prayers and thanksgiving for Canada. For Jessica, remembering those lost at Tiananmen Square. Diane, Sherry, Bruce. We pray together, and the bold print invites us to pray in unison. Maker and lover of all, in the mystery of your kindness, you have connected us to each other and called us to serve the earth and its people. So hear us as we pray for... Oh, now I would have done the prayers in the basket. I've done that already. Okay. So we offer you this prayer. Forgive in us what has gone wrong, repair in us what is wasted, reveal in us what is good. Amen.
Working? Yeah, there it is. I thank Vivian for getting my stole on correctly. I could see my wife looking in horror when I put it on. We gather at this table to remember Jesus, a man who showed us what God is like. Divine compassion moved into our neighborhood and we became part of God's circle dance. As we remember, we receive the grace of this table, transformation into the divine compassion of Christ. There is grace for us here. I wonder what grace you need. Grace to traverse a chasm between you and someone else. Grace to grow in compassion or generosity. Grace to do the circle dance. Grace to endure suffering and embrace the transformation awaiting you. Disciples, we are all needy at this table. We all seek union with God, the unknowable, to be caught up in God's circle dance, begging for bread that satisfies. Our Lord Jesus. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper had ended, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you many, and for many for the remission, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." We pray, Holy Spirit, transform.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
Come and receive the bread of the presence and the fruit of the circle dance. Amen. Together we pray as Jesus taught us. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Mother, holy and blessed is your true name. We pray for your reign, peace to come. We pray that your good will be done. Let heaven and earth become one. Give us this day the bread we need. Give it to those who have none. Let forgiveness flow like a river between us, from each one to each other. Lead us to holy innocence, beyond the evil of our days. Come swiftly, Mother, Father, come. For yours is the power and the glory and the mercy. Forever your name is all in one. Amen. Friends, receive the bread of the presence and the wine of the kingdom. Amen. So I invite a person from each table to come up and receive the bread.
While the table hosts are getting ready with their patens and the bread, I just want to remind everyone that anyone is invited to receive communion, no matter where you are on your faith journey or faith or doubt. And if you're not comfortable, feel free to pass the plate on. So four of the table hosts are now going to come forward to break the bread and collect it on the plate, and they'll bring the plate to the head of the tables. And we will pass the plate in the four lines. One, two, three, four. And then no passing across the table, please, okay? And then you hold the plate for the person that's sitting next to you, take a piece of bread, and then you can eat it, then pass the plate on. So again, take a piece of bread, eat it, pass it on to the next person. Okay? And the words are, "The body of Christ, food for the journey." So I think we're good. Thank you.
Thank you.
love and compassion. Help us to pause each day and whisper thank you for the most ordinary graces and gifts. In the way that you looked upon your creation and called everything so good, kindle in us that kind of generous vision. Lift us beyond our narrow concerns and help us to see how there is no separation. We are all connected. Support us in honoring our bodies as sacred temples and losing ourselves in the great cosmic dance. Amen.
Linda, would you like to come do the announcements now? Please and thank you.
Good morning. My name is Linda, and along with Vivian, we're the co-chairs of our parish council. If you're new to the church and would like to learn more, please contact the office, and you can get signed up for our very informative Friday newsletters. Or Sharon, Reverend Sharon, would be delighted to come and meet with you, but in 2 weeks' time, because she's on vacation right now. We want to thank Gary very much for coming and being with us today, and also our musicians, Erika Chow and her trio. Next. Next week, on June 11th, we have the Reverend Peter Smith, who works with the Mission to Seafarers. He'll be preaching and presiding, and we're going to have the Bell Choir back, and they will be providing music. And we're hoping to take up a special collection next week to support the Mission to Seafarers and the remarkable work they do. On June 25th, the Sunday after that, it's Indigenous Sunday. And at noon, our First Nations neighbors, the Tsleilwaututh, are doing a water blessing, and they've invited many faith communities on the North Shore to come and participate in this. We'll have more information for those who wish to attend closer to the date. We're also hoping to host some summer garden parties. We've done that the last 2 years. If you have a small yard and would like to host a summer garden party, please speak to Vivian or call the church and give them your name. All you have to do is provide the space. Everybody else brings the drink and the food, so it's very easy. You don't have to clean your house. Maybe you got to cut your lawn, I don't know, but you don't need to clean your house. It's a big advantage hosting something outside. Our next Soul Food Sunday won't be until October. We are doing this on the first Sunday of each month, as you know, but we won't be doing one over the summer season in July, August, or September. So October 1st, we'll be back having our breakfast Soul Food Sundays. Tony.
Just to let you know that the Millerairs Band is doing another benefit concert coming up on Tuesday, June the 27th, and again it'll be for the Learning Centre for the children with dyslexia. I have the tickets, so I'll be advertising it in the next few Sundays, but if you're interested, I have tickets. June the 27th, 7 p.m. here in the church. Thank you.
The Miller Ayres is a big band, and it's very worth hearing. Okay, so we've come to the end of the service, and this is just a reminder that we have offertory plates if you'd like to leave any contributions, one at the back, one at the side here. Again, we want to thank our musicians. They're very wonderful. We really appreciate all your wonderful music. And a reminder, don't forget to put your name tags away, because you get home and you're like me and you go, what the heck am I doing with this on still? Do we have any birthdays in May? Did we have any birthdays in May? Peter, oh my goodness, Shanti and Sharon. Oh my goodness, Alice. Oh my goodness, Julia. Holy moly. And person whose name I can't read? Robert, well done. Oh, and that's right, Peter Mercer, that's right. Well, that's pretty impressive. And Margaret. Wow, I should have just named everybody. That's very impressive. Well, a happy birthday belated to you all. Now we're going to end with a song that Alice and Penny are going to lead us in. What we'd like to do, if you feel like you've had a lot to eat right now, and so we need to get up and do a little exercise. So this song, if you could stand up as you're able behind your chairs so that you have something to hold on to. There is a part in the song which goes, your left foot say glory and your right say amen. And the demonstration goes like this. All right, so I'll be doing it up here. So as you're able, if you would all like to stand behind your chairs.
Joy, my friends, go on your way. Joy, my friends, go on your way. Joy, my friends, let your left foot say glory and your right say amen. Go on your way in peace, my friends. Go on your way in peace, my friends. Go on your way in peace, my friends. Let your left foot say glory. Go on your way in hope, my friends. Go on your way in hope, my friends. Go on your way in hope, my friends. Let your left foot say glory and your right say amen.
Okay, she wants it one more time.
You do too, darling. You're doing so well. Just one more.
Go on your way.
Go on your way and join my friends. Go on.
I think you've all found some new talents today, too. Okay, if you could be seated for the closing hymn. Prayer, blessing.
Yes. No, actually, stay standing, please.
We can't hear you, Gary.
As we go out into the world, let us be in awe of the mystery of the Incarnation, the circle dance of God. Let us activate the energy flow by dancing through our physical, psychological and spiritual relationships with each other and the unknowable one. May we move together with compassion, empathy, and trust in the name of God the Creator, God the Redeemer, and God the Sustainer. Amen.
Thank you, everyone. As our wonderful musicians are playing us out, if everyone could gently and quietly help take some of the cutlery back, that would be wonderful. Thank you very much.
John, would you help me with this?
Thank you.